Hello students, I am Manoj Kundare, the assistant professor of electronic science. Welcome back to our e-learning platform. In previous video, we have seen the various concepts like what is meant by latch, what is meant by flip-flop, difference between latch and flip-flop, SR latch, SR flip-flop and D flip-flop. The link of the previous video is available in the description box. Please check it. Now, let's summarize our previous lecture. In that video, we have seen the concept of SR latch. We know that the latch is a simple electronic circuit which is used to store a single binary bit. Okay, here this is the simple diagram of SR latch in which the two NAND gates are cross connected with each other. The first combination is S equal to 0 and R equal to 0. When S and R both equal to 0, then both the outputs Q and Q bar are forced to be 1, but practically it is not possible because Q bar is the complemented form of Q. Hence, when Q is equal to 1, Q bar must be equal to 0. Hence, here the race condition occurs and it should be avoided. Okay. Now, the next combination is S equal to 0 and R equal to 1. S equal to 0, hence the output of NAND gate 1 is forced to be 1, and at the same time this output of NAND gate 1 is connected with the input of NAND gate 2, hence we get here 1, hence the output of NAND gate 2 becomes 0. We get Q is equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0, hence we get here the set condition. The next combination is 1 0, that means S equal to 1 and R equal to 0. Now the output of NAND gate 2 is forced to be 1. At the same time this output is connected as the input of the first NAND gate, hence the input of the NAND gate first becomes 1 and 1, hence we get Q equal to 0. That means in this case we get Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1, hence we get the reset condition. Now the last condition is that when S equal to 1 and also R equal to 1. Here in this case we don't know what are the values of Q and Q bar. Let us assume Q has the value 0, then we get if Q equal to 0, then the input of NAND gate 2 also becomes 0. Hence, if any one input of the NAND gate is 0, then its output becomes forced to be 1. If Q bar equal to 1, then Q must be 0. Hence, we get here no change condition in 1 and 1 combination. The latch is in inactive state. Okay, now let's see the positive edge triggered SR flip-flop. We know that in flip-flop an additional clock input is provided with a control circuitry. For a control circuit the two NAND gates are added. I hope you all remember these things. Let's see the truth table for positive edge triggered SR flip-flop. We are going to see the positive edge triggered SR flip-flop. Hence the low level clock means no change condition, 1 means high level clock means no change condition, the falling edge clock means the no change condition or inactive state. When the first rising edge of the clock occurs, then S and R inputs are active. The first combination is S equal to 0, R equal to 0. Okay, when the S equal to 0, that means output of NAND gate 1 is forced to 1. Similarly, R is equal to 0, that means output of NAND gate 2 is forced to 1. And we know that when SR has the combination 1 and 1, then it is in the no change condition. Okay, I hope you all remember these things. Now, arrival of second positive edge or rising edge, S becomes 0 and R becomes 1. Here s becomes 0, hence output of NAND gate 1 is 1. Okay, and output of NAND gate 2 is 0. Hence the output of NAND gate 4 is forced to be 1 because its one input is 0. This one is connected to the input of NAND gate 3, hence the output of NAND gate 3 is 0. That means we get Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. That means the reset condition. Okay, similarly we can see the arrival of third rising edge or positive edge. The combination becomes S equal to 1 and R equal to 0. Here R equal to 0, hence the output of NAND gate 2 is forced to be 1 and the output of NAND gate 1 is forced to be 0. Okay, here the NAND gate 3 input is 0, hence its output is forced to be 1 and Q bar is 0. Hence we get Q is equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. That means the set condition. Now on the arrival of fourth clock pulse, we get S equal to 0, sorry, S equal to 1 and R equal to 1. Okay, when S equal to 1 and R equal to 1, the output of NAND gate 1 is 0. Similarly, output of NAND gate 2 is 0. That means we get S equal to 0, R equal to 0. In latch, we know that this occurs the race condition, and the race condition should be avoided. I hope you all remember these things. From SR flip-flop, we have derived the D flip-flop. Okay, how is it possible? The S and R, in between S and R input, we place a NOT gate. Okay, that means we get only 0-1 or 1-0 condition of SR flip-flop. Okay, that means 0-1 or 1-0. We are going to see positive edge triggered, hence the low level means no change, high level means no change, falling edge means no change. First rising edge occurs, then S equal to 0 and R equal to 1. Because here a NOT gate is connected, we get reset condition. When the second rising edge occurs, the combination becomes 1-0. That means we get the set condition. We can also say that the D flip-flop is used to obtain only the set and reset conditions. Okay, I hope you all remember these things. Now let's see our today's topic, the negative edge triggered JK flip-flop. Okay, in JK flip-flop, the clock input is connected with this control circuit. Okay, in this circuit diagram, we can see that the NAND gate first and the NAND gate second has the three inputs. Okay, the another input is connected from, that means the Q bar is connected with the input of NAND gate 1. Similarly, the Q, that means the output, is connected with the NAND gate 2. That means there is a feedback path is connected. Okay, I hope you all understand the difference between circuit diagram of SR flip-flop and JK flip-flop. Now let's see the truth table of negative edge triggered JK flip-flop. Okay, we are going to see negative edge triggered. That means when clock 0 occurs, there is no change. Clock 1 occurs, there is no change. These are for level triggered flip-flop, but we are going to see edge triggered. When the rising edge occurs, then there is also no change, because we are going to see the negative edge triggered JK flip-flop. Okay, that means when the first falling edge occurs, J equal to 0 and K equal to 0. J equal to 0, Similarly, at the same time, k equal to 0. Here, j equal to 0 and k equal to 0. Hence, the output of both the NAND gates are forced to be 1. That means, the output of NAND gate first is 1. Similarly, the output of NAND gate second is also 1. And we know that if one condition occurs, then we get the no change condition. Okay? Then, on the arrival of second falling edge or second negative edge, we get the combination j equal to 0 and k equal to 1. When j equal to 0, we get the output of NAND gate 1 is at the same time the output of NAND gate 2 is 0. Okay, I hope you all understand this concept. The output of NAND gate 2 is 0, that means the input of NAND gate 4 is 0. Hence, we get Qn bar is equal to 1, and at the same time, we get Qn equal to 0. Hence, we get the 0, 1 condition. Hence, we get the reset condition here. Similarly, we can see the next combination. On the arrival of third negative edge, we get j equal to 1 and k equal to 0. When j equal to 1 and k equal to 0, that means the output of NAND gate 2 is forced to be 1 and the output of NAND gate 1 is forced to be 0. The input of NAND gate 3 is 0, hence Qn equal to 1, and here we get Qn bar equal to 0. That means we get Qn equal to 1 and Qn bar equal to 0. That means we get the set condition. Now, the arrival of fourth negative edge, we get both j and k equal to 1, 1. Okay. In this case, we don't know what are the values of Qn and Qn bar. Let's assume that the value of Qn is 0. Okay. Hence, this 0 is connected with the input of the NAND gate 2. That means the one input of NAND gate 2 becomes 0. Hence, we get here the output 1. Okay. When Qn equal to 0, Qn bar equal to 1, and it is connected with the input of NAND gate 1. Hence, we get here 1. Hence, the output of NAND gate 1 is forced to 0. Okay. Now, what happens? The input of NAND gate 3 is 0. Hence, we get Qn equal to 1. What happened here? We assume that Qn equal to 0, but we get Qn equal to 1. That means we get 0 to 1. Okay. Let's see once again. On the arrival of fourth negative edge, j equal to 1, k equal to 1, we don't know what are the values of Qn and Qn bar. Let us assume that Qn equal to 0 and automatically Qn bar becomes 1. The Qn equal to 0 means one input of NAND gate 2 becomes 0, while the one input of NAND gate 1 becomes 1. Here, one input of NAND gate 2 is 0, hence its output is forced to 1. At the same time, the output of NAND gate 1 is 0 because its all inputs has the values 1. Okay. Now, we get here the input of NAND gate 3 is 0, hence we get Qn equal to 1. We assume that Qn equal to 0, but we get Qn equal to 1. Hence, if Qn equal to 1, then Qn bar becomes 0. That means we get the toggle condition. Okay. This is called as toggle condition, because we assume that Qn equal to 0, but after simplification we get Qn equal to 1. That means 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, that means the toggling of bit. I hope you all understand what is mean by toggle condition. Okay, from this JK flip-flop we can derive T flip-flop, such as the J and K terminals are connected directly with each other and we get the T flip-flop. Okay, the truth table, in this truth table if J and K equal to 1, if J and K are connected with each other directly, then we get if J equal to 0, K is equal to also 0. If J equal to 1, K is equal to also 1. That means the 0, 1 and 1, 0 conditions are removed and we get only 0, 0 and 1, 1 condition. That means no change and toggle condition. I hope you all understand. We are going to see the negative edge trigger T flip-flop. Hence the clock 0 means no change, clock 1 means no change, positive edge means no change. On the arrival of first falling edge or first negative edge, we get both the inputs J and K equal to 0, 0. That means we get the no change condition. On the arrival of second falling edge, we get the 1, 1 condition. Here is 1. 1, 1 condition, that means we get the toggle condition. That means we can say that the T flip-flop is used to derive the toggle condition only. Okay, I hope you all understand the negative edge triggered JK flip-flop and the T flip-flop. Now the next point is, what is mean by race around condition? Let's see the answer of this question. We know that the race around condition occurs in JK flip-flop when J equal to 1 and K equal to 1. Let's see the detailed answer about this question. The race around condition occurs in the level triggered JK flip-flop. Okay, this is the very important thing, that the race around condition occurs in the level triggered JK flip-flop. The race around condition occurs when J equal to K equal to 1, that means both the inputs have the value 1, then the JK flip-flop is in toggle mode. As long as JK equal to 1 and clock equal to 1, the outputs will keep toggling indefinitely. This multiple toggling in JK flip-flop is called as the race around condition. That means in level triggered JK flip-flop, when J equal to K equal to 1, then the JK flip-flop is in toggle mode, and we know that what is mean by toggling. That means transition from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. Okay, 1 0 1 0 1 0, this is called as toggling. And when J equal to K equal to 1, clock equal to 0, then the outputs are keep toggling. Hence this condition is called as the race around condition. Then how it is avoided? The race around condition in JK flip-flop can be avoided by first using the edge triggered JK flip-flop or using the master slave JK flip-flop. We have already seen the edge triggered JK flip-flop. Now see the master slave JK flip-flop. In this master slave JK flip-flop, we clearly seen there are two flip-flops. The first one is JK flip-flop, which is acts as the master, and second is SR flip-flop, which is acts as the slave. Okay, and the clock signals are complemented with each other. That means at the clock of both flip-flops, a inverter is placed. That means when master is active, slave is inactive. Similarly, when master is inactive, slave is active. I hope you all understand the concept of JK flip-flop, T flip-flop and race around condition. Thank you.